Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. A warm welcome to the third day of the third Global Education and Skill Conclave. We had a couple of very inspiring sessions in the morning, and now we are joined by another eminent speaker, Dr. Indrajit Bhattacharya, who is the director of the National Accreditation Board for Education and Training, which is incidentally a constituent board of Quality Council of India. I would now like to welcome Dr. Bhattacharya to talk about in terms of the and especially in these post-pandemic times when the different learning mode needs certain evolution. So the question of maintaining the quality and having quality control becomes even more imperative. So in this light, I will welcome Dr. Bhattacharya to have a session where he can talk about how things are happening as far as quality control of education and training is concerned. Over to you, Dr. Bhattacharya.
So good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me a great pleasure to participate in this APAC conference of education and skills. I would like to take you through a couple of slides that I have here. Let me share my screen. Is it visible? Is the screen visible? Is the screen visible? Can anybody reply?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, thank you very much for inviting me to speak at this Global Education Skill Conclave. I belong to the National Accreditation Board for Education and Training, as Mr. Day has said. So we are moving during the pandemic times, both the employee scenario as well as in the student scenario. It is the work anytime movement, work anywhere, use any device, focus on outputs, create your own ladder, have a customized work. And more importantly, focus on the adaptive learning, which I will talk in my session. Before that, Quality Council of India is an independent autonomous body under the Ministry of Commerce, and it's a non-profit organization. It was constituted in 97, and we are going to complete 25th year in 2022, the Silver Jubilee year. Our chairman is Mr. Adil Zainul Bhai, a ex-Harvard and IIT Bombay alumni with 34 years in McKinsey and nominated by the Prime Minister. We have the Secretary General as Dr. R.P. Singh, alumnus of BHU and Western University of Canada, appointed by the Minister of Commerce and Industry. So this is the organizational structure. We have accreditation boards of certification body. I come from the Accreditation Board of Education and Training. Then we have a board for healthcare providers and the calibration laboratories, calibration and testing laboratories board. Then we have a quality promotion board, and under the special projects group, we have the project planning implementation division, the project analysis division, and the zero defect and zero effect division. So if we talk about what is going on in the NABET, it is a constituent board of QCI mandated for the assessments, evaluation, and accreditation of education and training institutes in the skill area. So under that, we have the FEED, which is the formal excellence division, looking at the K-12 segment, the schools quality improvement projects, and the government projects, etc. In the environment division, we have an accreditation scheme of the environment impact consultant assessments and the groundwater consultants and the mining organizations accreditation. In the skill training division, we have a scheme for learning service providers, which I'll explain in my coming slides. And in the MSME division, we have the lean manufacturing competitive scheme, improving the MSMEs segment. The slide is not moving. Okay. So in the formal education excellence division, we have accreditation schools, the training and teacher assessment pedagogies, quality intervention of projects, and the research studies. Third part. studies for the Ministry of Education, the Junjunu and Sikar district schools, then the CBSE schools, the assessments of schools and residential hostels in government of Odisha, the Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti, and the DAV committee of Chhattisgarh's accreditation of those schools. Then under the Fit India School Movement, we have addressed the 250 schools we have assessed. Then we have a project under the National Commission for Protection of Child Rights that we have addressed. Just let me. Then in the Army Public Schools, we have done the assessments and accreditation. Then under CBSE affiliated schools, we addressed those. And under the National Education Policy 2020, we have been a part of the Haryana State Level Consultation, as well as the CBSE Standard Setting Committee. Under the higher education arena, we have formal education addressing the higher education in the, institutions, the basic requirements of education organization in governance, infrastructure, curriculum, inclusivity, and sustainability in specialist institutions of ITIs, polytechnics, and diploma institutions, and in B.Ed. and sports and nutrition, etc. So towards focusing on the research area, as is the focus of the National Education Policy, we have addressed the third-party accreditation, third-party assessments of Uchitar Avishkar Yojana, as well as the impacting the research and innovation technology. We've done the third-party evaluation of 450 projects, wherein we saw that there are under the imprint domains, there are 10 areas we have which have been bucketed, as you can see, in healthcare, in ICT, energy, sustainable habitat, nanotechnology hardware, water resources, advanced materials, manufacturing, security and defense, and environmental science. But when we started assessing, we saw that most of these domains have been multidisciplinary, and now there's a new term called pluridisciplinary, which makes it more important that the today's professionals focus on multidisciplinary domains. Same is with the Indian Institute of Science projects, which have the thrust areas of physical science, chemical science, biological science, and nanoscience, data science, and earth science under the STAR scheme, which is Scheme for Transformation of Advanced Research and Science. more than 140 projects are under evaluation. These have been bucketed in the technology readiness level, which goes from idea to prototype to validation to production. In the indicators for the academic training institutes on ground is training institute governance, learning centricity and alignment, training and support processes, which you can see. These are the aspects which are seen. But while we have moved online on the blended learning approach in the learning service provider, the aspects which have been seen are the trainer, the infrastructure, the program design and delivery, and the training management system, which is the three dimensions of hardware, software, and humanware. To take it further, we are seeing that in the lines of what is happening with the autonomous vehicles, the same is being moving on the online space, where with the focus of teacher only, and with the coming in of artificial intelligence, it has been teacher assisted movement, the partial automation, conditional automation, high automation, and full automation. Towards this one, maturity assessment model for evaluation of EdTech tools have been proposed, which has these buckets of intelligent tutoring system with a weightage of 30%, the education management information systems with a weightage of 25%, the research-based learning, the weightage of 20%, with the degree of automation with a weightage of 15%, and a very important IT security, ethics and standards with the space of, with the elements of accountability, explainability, transparency and privacy with a weightage of 10%. So if you are an EdTech organization or an institution, please reply on this email of ib.nabet@qcin.org whether you agree or you disagree on this. Next. Again, the slide is not moving. Yes. So we have a role in the QCI cybersecurity space where NABET is involved in a consultant organization as well as training providers accreditation scheme, which is happening currently. In the Ministry of MSME's Lean Competitive Scheme space, we are implementing the lean tools and techniques for improving the quality, eliminating the waste and reducing the time and reducing the total cost. This is happening since 2014, wherein the completion of 94 clusters involving about 768 MSMEs, a return on investment of seven times the investment has been foreseen, with a host of benefits which have been realized by the various MSMEs. So the automation from now on is going to enhance quality and inequality, and moving towards sustainable automation will balance quality as well as equality, moving towards circular economy, going on riding on the Industry 4.0 and Industry 5.0 wave. So the upskilled LMCS 2020 scheme is under development by the Ministry of MSME with the focus on low cost automation to partially automate the manufacturing process and reducing the defects, labor cost and improving the quality. So the body of knowledge is being conceived by the Ministry of MSME in the lines of what Tagore said, where knowledge is free. Into that heaven of freedom, my father let my country awake. So the body of knowledge towards the upskilled scheme is being conceived. And the recommendations of NEP 2020 bearing the EduTech model talks about 360-degree progress card, which we are going to focus on. And the standards in e-learning needs to be addressed on the SCORM compliance, as well as IEC 2016 and IEC 19796 models. So any NEFT, you all know, focuses on integration of ICT in the terms of teaching learning, evaluation, teacher preparation, education access, educational planning, educational management, and educational assessments. AI and education, all of us know, has a deep role in the space of AI for education, AI education, and AI in education. I'll skip these slides because of paucity of time. And this is the last slide for recommendations. Content has to be relevant and experiential. It has to be SCORM compliant, personalized and gamified learning platforms, student friendly with low bandwidth mobile apps, and continuous assessments and evaluation of training facilities required both physical and online to enhance quality. Have third-party quality accreditation, witness assessments and surprise assessments, and asynchronous learning beyond assignments and home works. So increasing the gross enrollment ratio with AI-driven student engagement online and the monitoring by faculty is what we recommend. Thank you very much. This is a program that we have for smart teachers over eQuest platform of Quality Council of India. Thank you very much. With this last statement of Vivekanand, which is arise awake and stop not till the goal is reached. Atmanirbhar goal is reached. Over to Mr. Day. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Bhattacharya. That was wonderful in terms of some of the initiatives on quality control that you talked about. And I'm sure this would inspire about 3,000 plus educators who have been watching the conclave over the last 3 days. Thanks, Dr. Bhattacharya, and thank wish you. You a good day. Thank you.
Yeah, I'd like to take leave. Thank you.